Hi there. Today I want to show a very quick integration of Microsoft Outlook with Dynamics 365 Business Central. And I'm going to start by showing you how you set it up quickly and then a little bit of what you can do with Outlook after you've got it set up. So let's see what this looks like. I'm logged into Business Central and I'm going to go in and use an assisted setup. This is Molly Clark, so assisted setup. I'm going to search for assisted setup in the system, and I found that page. And I'm going to repeat the process, but basically in assisted setup, I have different types of setups that I can do, setting up sales taxes, setting up approval workflows. In this case, I want to set up my business inbox in Outlook. So it warns me I've already completed it. I'll just repeat it so that people can see how it's done. Now the user who's going to do this has to have permissions to do the setup. The administrator can do it for the entire company. I'm just doing it as Molly here. So as you can see, Molly's going to do it for her mailbox. She could, if she was the administrator, choose to do it for the organization. It's going to ask me, do I want to send a sample message? I have already sent one, so we'll take a look at it in the inbox when I've done. I hit next and finish, and the system will connect to Exchange Online and configure the Business Central add-in. So let's take a look at what that looks like. Let's minimize out of here and we'll go to Outlook. So let's log into Outlook and take a look at that email that we've got. Okay, so we have an inbox email from Microsoft that was sent to us by Business Central basically to test the system. And this is a nice email because it gives us a couple of little samples to work with. It has a little table in the email that gives an example of something that a customer would want. So what we could do to basically demonstrate the way the software works is we can go up here to the menu bar where we have the Business Central icons added to our menu. And we could click Contact Insights. And it's going to cross-reference the email sender with contacts and customer records inside Business Central. So let's make this a little bit wider so we could see it more clearly. And here we could see that this sender is related to a Datum Corporation, which has come up with a lot of information, tells us what our sales were, tells us how many current outgoing sales quotes and orders, etc., that we have. Now, because there's a little table on this email, what we can do is we can now go in and we can create a new document. Now I could also do this simply from this screen as well. And the type of documents I can create depend a little bit on what type of contact I found. So if I found a vendor contact, this would allow me to create purchase orders. If I found a sales contact, obviously you see it's more sales oriented. So let me create a sales quote. So Microsoft has programmed the system to use artificial intelligence to go through and take a look at what it finds in the email, and it has found a item with a quantity, item description and quantity in the email, and it's cross-referenced it through the system and found two items that match, three it thinks. The guest section one does not appear to be anywhere on here. Maybe that it picked it up from some of this, but let me get rid of that. And the two items are clearly the London swivel chair and the Antwerp conference table. Those are both listed and the quantities are automatically discovered. So let me say okay to that. And now what I have is I have a prepared quote that's ready to go. Let's make a little adjustment. Let's mark it up a bit. I know that these guys really want these badly and I can charge a little extra for them. And what I'll do is I will send by email. And as soon as I do that, I'm going to open up an email with this quote attached that is to Contoso. It automatically knows who I'm sending it to. It has a nice PDF of the email attached to it. Let's double click on that. There's our sales quote that's attached automatically by the system. Looks very nice. And we have a little summary of it here for them with the total. And it's automatically signed. Now in this case it's signed by Peter because Peter is this customer's sales rep. I would just hit send and I'm done. And by the way, I could also do something very similar by hitting reply. And now I can do a new sales quote. So now I have the same suggestion for sales quote, but I'm going about it a slightly different way. I'll click OK. And because I've started replying to the email, when I send by email, it will simply embed it right in the email I had already started. Well, thanks very much for taking a couple minutes to see how Outlook integrates with Business Central. If you'd like to learn more, you can contact us at www.saberlimited.com and keep your eye on our YouTube channel for new YouTube videos.